Tai Chi Chuan is commonly known as Tai Chi and originated in China over 1,000 years ago during the Song Dynasty. It is the most famous martial arts style of the internal schools. Nowadays, Tai Chi Chuan is well known as the ultimate form of exercise for the improvement and maintenance of health. If you wish to see the demonstration of the complete 24 forms first, please fast forward to 1 hour 45 minutes. This simple and powerfully effective art form has been proven to relax and yet strengthen both the mind and the body, and is considered suitable for people of almost any age and level of fitness. Tai Chi Chuan utilizes ancient Chinese philosophies and techniques which harmonize the mind and the body, allowing them to work together as one. Regular practice of Tai Chi Chuan will make the practitioner more relaxed, much fitter and healthier. There are many different styles and forms of Tai Chi Chuan, and it's often difficult and confusing to decide which style or forms to learn. In 1956, the Chinese National Sports Committee authorized the country's foremost renowned Tai Chi Chuan experts to devise a suitable forms for most people. After much research, the 24 forms, based on mainly Yang style, was created. It retains all the essential principles of Tai Chi Chuan and is tailored to modern needs. For the purpose of improving mental and physical health, 24 forms is considered to be perfectly suitable for students of almost any level of physical fitness and age. At the third International Wushu and Tai Chi Chuan competition in Beijing, China, 1993, Paul Lam won a gold medal for the combined 42 forms, achieving the highest individual score of all men's events. At the same competition, Cam Lau Fung and Sybil Wong won a bronze medal each for the 24 forms Tai Chi Chuan. This video is divided into three parts: the 6 Qigong exercises, the 7 single movements, and the 24 forms. It is designed for these parts to be learned either together or separately, and in any order pending on personal preference. We found the best sequence is to learn one Qigong exercise followed by one single movement. Having learnt the first 2 single movements, we start the 24 forms until form 4. We then go back to do the 3rd single movement and back to the 24 forms until form 6, and so on. In this way, you won't feel bolted down by the slower first 2 parts. A few words of advice before we start. Please warm up before you begin by doing some gentle stretching exercises for your whole body. Take care not to overexert yourself. Do all movements slowly and gently and in a fairly upright stance to begin with. Later on, when you're more proficient, you'll be able to lower your stance. You might find it helpful to practice in front of a mirror or have someone video your efforts for you to view later. Above all, be patient. Learn each movement carefully and accurately, only moving on to the next when you are confident that you can perform the first accurately.
Hello, I'm Paul Lam. Welcome to 24 Form Tai Chi Chuan. We shall start with a few hand positions and stances.
Hand. The hand is held open with the 4 fingers close together without actually touching. The thumb is held open in a natural manner, in the same plane as the fingers, with all the fingers curved very slightly. In this position, the circulation of blood and qi are maximized. Hook hand. Hold the fingers together close to the thumb in a natural, relaxed manner and bend the wrist. Fist. Gently clench the four fingers onto the palm, placing the thumb over the middle part of the index and middle fingers. Relax the whole fist.
Bow stang. A bow stang is the foot in the front is facing straight ahead, with most of the weight resting on this foot. The kneecap should be in the same line as the toe, and the foot in the back should point at 45 degrees and about 30% of the weight on that foot. Both your feet should be separate by a width of the shoulder. When moving your back foot to this position, in this case, the right foot, usually from the 90-degree position to the 45-degree position, you must push your right heel backwards with the force directing from your hip. This way will give you more stability and help your chi to sink down. If you simply move your right toes forward, there won't be any more stability. However, there are times this is done differently because of different reasons. I will point it out as they happen in the form.
Empty stance. In this stance, all the weight is kept on one foot, with the other foot usually only partly touching the ground.
I will also use the hands of the clock as a guide to your direction. When I say turning to your right, I mean turning to Ian's right. And Ian will be performing as though you are doing the form. And to Ian's right is 3 o'clock. Behind Ian is 6 o'clock. To his left is 9 o'clock. And 45 degrees in front of him is 1:30. 45 degrees to the left side of him is 10:30. We will now do the 6 Qigong exercises. What are Qigong? In Chinese, Qigong has 2 words. The first word, Qi, means a life energy circulating inside your body. The stronger your qi is, the stronger you are and the healthier you are. Gong, the second word here, means a form of exercise. So these qigong exercises are special breathing techniques aimed at improving your qi and postures. It is very beneficial for mental relaxation, and it's also very important at building a good foundation for Tai Chi training.
Number 1, the posture of infinity.
At the beginning of all basic exercise, you start with open feet, which means your feet are separated by shoulder width and parallel to each other. Relax, get yourself ready, cleanse your mind, don't think of anything except what you're going to do. Relax your head. Tuck your chin slightly in, relax your shoulder, leave a small space in between the armpits, relax your hands, relax your hip, relax your knee, do not push your knee backwards. And start. Bring your hands up slowly, as though there's 2 balloons lifting them up. And as you bring it up, just as slow as your hands move out, breathing slowly. Press your hands down as though there's 2 balloons underneath your hands. Keep your palms parallel to the ground. And as you press down, bend your knee so that your kneecap is at the same line as your toe. And maintain your body straight, and your hands is about your chest level. And breathe out as you press down. Now it's very important to keep your back straight. Ian will turn around to show you how straight it should be. It should be a straight line from here down to here. Okay, we'll go back. Okay. Then continue. Then next, you turn your hands around so they make a circle around you with the palm face you. Make sure your elbow is slightly below the hands and the shoulder. Make sure your body is relaxed and both arms are parallel to each other. Your eyes look straight ahead or slightly lower than that. And of course, always keep your body straight. Now, the basic exercise is sort of easy in the outside appearance, especially the first exercise, but it really gets deeper as you know your Tai Chi training better, and it can be fairly difficult as you know it better. And in here, what I like you to concentrate is the inside. Put your tongue on top of the upper palate, close your mouth slightly. Once you cleanse your mind, think of nothing or something really serene or tranquil, and relax. And then next thing, you should think of sinking your qi down to the dang tiang. The dang tiang is where you store the qi, which is about 3 finger breath, just below the umbilicus. For the beginners who's not sure how to do this, all you have to do is think of the dang tiang, think of that position, and the feeling of the qi will eventually come to you after a lot of practice. So when you feel your knees are shaking, you are getting a little bit tired, don't force it. You can finish this move. Straighten your hands and bring it up to shoulder height again. And then as you breathe out, gently press your hands down, and at the same time, gently stand up.
Number 2, the posture of expansion and contraction.
The Qigong exercise number 2 started exactly the same as number 1. When you reach this position, relax, get ready. And you expand your hands. As your hands open against each other, imagine there is an invisible magnet attracting your hands. So you have to open your hands against some mild resistance, and maintain palm face each other. Keep your body straight, and as you open up, breathe in slowly, as slow as you open your hands. You breathe slowly. Use abdominal breathing, which means that you imagine your air go all the way through to the stomach, and as you breathe in, your stomach swell up slightly. Now then, you press both palms against each other as though there is a mild resistance against it. And again, the palm face each other. And as you press them together, breathe out. Again, with abdominal breathing, means you breathe through your stomach and your stomach becomes depressed. And here, it's important to make sure all the breathing are done through your nose. And that is one of the reasons why you put your tongue on top of the upper palate and keep your mouth gently closed, not tightly closed. And you can continue to do this for as long as you are able to do it comfortably. Do not force your breathing. If you find your breathing getting difficult, then you just stop this abdominal breathing and breathe naturally. And once you have enough or feel your legs getting a bit tired, your breathing gets difficult, you can then finish off. And finishing off is exactly the same as the first Qigong exercise.
Number three, the posture of up and down.
Again, the number three Qigong exercise is the same as number one. Bring your hands up slowly and breathe in. This is basically very similar to basic exercise one. When you press your hands down, the difference is you bring your hands lower down to the umbilicus level, which means the belly button level. And as you press your hands down, breathe out with the abdominal breathing and maintain your body straight. Then as you bring your hands up, breathe in. Now, one of the difficult things of this movement is to coordinate your hands and your knee. Once you press down with your hands, then you start bending your knee. And they both got to be done very slowly, gently, and you got to breathe gently too. And once your hands down to the umbilical level, your knee will be just in the right level that the kneecap is at the same line as your toe. So it takes a lot of practice to coordinate that. And this can be done continuously for as long as you like. Do not, again, force your breathing. And when you feel you have enough, then you can stop. If this Qigong exercise gets a little bit difficult, an experienced teacher will be helpful here. Okay, then you can finish off.
Number four, the posture of playing the lute.
Start it the same way. Bring your hands up. Press your palms down to the umbilical height. Open your hands up. Then with the movement of your waist, bring your hands together. Left hand, eye level height. Your eyes looking at the tip of the left index finger. Make sure your elbow is slightly bent, your shoulder relaxed. Right hand is guarding the left elbow. And as you do this, lift your left foot up. Bring your left foot to face 10-30 position. And the left heel should be just a little bit in front of where the left toe was when it started. And when you reach this position, make sure your body is straight and relax and use abdominal breathing. Staying as long as you like, but don't overdo it. When your thigh gets a little bit tight, you can finish off. When you finish off, bring your hands together to shoulder height. Be sure your knee is still in the bending position. And then we do the right hand side position. Basically, the right and the left hand is the same, except you are now facing the 130 position. And again, stay for as long as you like until your thighs getting a little bit tight, and then you can finish off.
Number 5, stepping forwards.
The next two exercises, we start with a different position. Your feet is like Charlie Chaplin, with the heel touching and both feet separated by about 90 degrees. And your hands is in the back. Ian will turn around to show you where your hands should be. Just above the hip bone, in there, there's a position of two acupuncture points where the teeth are centered. And the wrist should be pressing gently on those points. Palm face outside and hands relaxed, shoulder relaxed. We'll continue. Sink down. By bending your knee down, maintain your body straight, kneecap same line as your toe. Step your left foot forward so that only your left heels are touching ground. And you are stepping forward by a gentle curve, and both feet still separate by shoulder width. And the toes are facing straight away. Here, it's very important to keep your body straight. Bring your weight forward so that your kneecap is the same line as your toe. Transfer your weight back. In here, a lot of people have problem keeping the body straight, so be careful with that. Turn your body 45 degrees to face 10-30 position. Now to turn this, you basically have to turn your hip, not just your toe. And your hip take your toe towards 10-30 position. Your toe still above ground. Put your weight forward. Bring the right foot next to the left. Step your right foot forward this time, again in a curve. Again, keep the width of both feet and the right toes facing straight away, straight forward. Weight forward. Transfer your weight back, keep your hip bent. Turn your waist to 130 position. Put your weight forward and bring your left foot next to the right, heel touching. Don't stand up yet, and then you stand up afterwards. Bring your hands down. I'll demonstrate the foot movements. First of all, bend down. Then bring your foot forward to the left, be sure only your heel is touching ground. Then the weight forward, and when you transfer your weight back, make sure your hip is bent and your body is straight. And once you turn, it's very important to turn with your hip moving, not toes moving and hip not moving. That is wrong. So I do it the right way again. Turn with your hip and then bring your toe down. Now your toe should be facing 10-30, and bring the right foot up and continue the same way on the other side.
Number 6, stepping backwards.
Again, we start with the same position as Qigong exercise 5. Feet the same way, 90 degrees apart. And this time the hands are in front of you. Bring the left hand in first, and then put the right hand over the left, palm on palm. The hand's position is just below the umbilicus. And it is a good idea, according to the tradition. For men, the left hand goes in first, the left hand closer to your abdomen first. And for ladies, the right hand goes first, then the left. Sink, again, keep your body straight. Here, step back with your left foot. Step back in a curve, and with your left toe touch ground first. Then, shift the weight to the left foot. Here, it's very important to keep your body really, really straight. And lift the right heel up, and then straighten your foot so that now your right toe is facing straight ahead. Now bring your right foot in a gentle curve, pass beside the left foot to touch down behind you with the toes touch down first. Be sure you maintain the shoulder width between 2 feet. And again, sit back on the right side, lift the left heel up, and pivoting on the ball of the foot, straighten the left foot so that the left toes are facing straight forward. Join your feet together, then stand up and let your hands down. Again, this can be done continuously. We shall now do the 7 single movements. These movements are the most important and the most characteristic movements of the 24-Fong Tai Chi Chuan. Each movement has its own beginning and its own ending. So each movement can be an independent miniature set of Tai Chi Chuan. So when we start with the Fong, we simply join them together.
Parting Wild Horse's Mane.
All single movements started the same with the Qigong exercise, except feet are together as we started. First of all, lift your left heel up first, then bring the left foot out and put your left toe down first and then the whole foot. Now your foot should be shoulder width and parallel to each other. Bring your hands up slowly, gently to shoulder height. Press down with your hands, palms parallel to the ground, knee bent at the same time, keep your back straight. Turn your body slightly around. Turn your hands around to carry a ball with the right hand on top. Step out with the left foot so that your left foot is facing 9 o'clock. As you transfer your weight to the left and turn your waist to the left, open up your hands in a curve so that your left hand is shoulder height, facing upwards and inwards. Right hand next to the hip, in front and next to the hip. There is a gentle curve here. transfer your weight backwards and turn your left toe inwards. So now your left toe is pointing straight ahead at 90 degrees, and your left hand is on top, right hand at the bottom carrying a ball. Repeat the same thing except different sides. So step your right foot forward towards 3 o'clock. Separate your hands so that the right hand is up there pointing at 3 o'clock, left hand next to the hip. Now, I must point out here again, this is the same. When we form the right ball stand, make sure you push your left heel backwards with the sinking of your hip to make the left toe turning to face 130. Transfer your weight backwards and bring the right toe inwards to face in front and bring your right hand over. As you bring the right hand over to face down, bring the left hand around in a small curve to reach the same shoulder width, shoulder height. Bring the left foot back so that both feet now parallel to each other and shoulder width. As you press your palms down gently, stand up gently at the same time. Lift up your left heel first, then the left toe touch ground first. Bring both feet together.
Two, brush knee.
Same as single movement number one, separate your feet first. Still the same, bring your hands up. Down to the umbilical level. As you turn your hands up in a curve, so the right hand is pointing at 130, left hand turn next to the right elbow to guard the elbow. Look at the right hand. Step forward with the left foot towards 9 o'clock. As you shift your weight forward and turn your waist to the left, push your right hand past your right ear to the chest height. At the same time, your left hand brush past your knee to end it in front and next to your hip. Fingers face forward. That's a gentle curve here. Transfer your weight backwards and bring your left palm up, right palm next to the left elbow to guard the elbow. Turn your left toe inwards so that your left foot is facing straight ahead. Bring your hands around. So now the left hands are pointing at 10:30. You're looking at the left hand. Bring the right foot next to the left. Step your right foot forward towards 3 o'clock. Again, as your right hand brush past your knee, push forward with your left hand. At the same time, don't forget to push the heel in the back of your ball stand. In this case, it's the left foot. The heel is to be pushed backwards with the sinking of your left hip. Transfer your weight backwards and lift up the right palm. Turn your right toe inwards so that your right foot is facing straight ahead. Bring the left foot close to the right foot so that both feet are now separate by shoulder width and parallel to each other. Bring both hands up so the hands are shoulder width, and be sure you don't stand up, keep your body straight. As you press your palm down slowly, now you stand up slowly. And bring your foot together.
3. Repulse monkey.
As before, separate your feet. Hands up slowly. Hands down slowly to the umbilical level. Here, bring both your hands around in a gentle curve, as though you're carrying a small ball here, with palm face each other, fingers face forward. As you push your right palm forward, form an angle with your wrist, so you bend your palm upwards about 45 degrees. Bring your left palm back so that it is next to your hip and in front of your hip, palms facing up. Turn your waist, and with the turning of the waist, take your left hand over to the 7:30 position. As you turn back and look straight ahead, bring your left hand next to your ear. Push the left hand forward and bring the right hand slightly backwards, back to the carrying small ball situation. Again, push your left hand forward and this time bring the right hand next to the hip. Turn your waist to the right and bring the right hand to face 4:30 position. And looking back straight ahead and bring your right hand next to your right ear. Now, like all the other single movements, we demonstrate right and left of each movement, but you can do this in continuation. It can continue until you are tired or run out of rooms. Bring the right hand forward, left hand back to carry a small ball. Separate your hands so that both hands are shoulder width and shoulder height. And again, don't stand up. As you stand up slowly, press your hands down slowly. Feet together.
4. Stroking bird's tail.
Separate your feet. Hands up slowly to shoulder height. Hands down and bend your knee. Carrying a ball. Step your left foot out towards 9 o'clock. Walk off with your left hand so that your left hand or the left arm forms a circular shape. Elbow should be lower than your wrist and your shoulder. This is called sinking your elbow. This should make you stronger. And palms are facing you. And you look straight ahead. Bring your right hand down in a gentle curve to be in front of the right hip. When you form the left bow stand here, be sure you push your right heel backwards with your hip so that your right toes is now facing or pointing at 10:30. Turn your waist slightly and Turn both your palms. Roll back as you transfer your weight. Roll back with your hands. This means as though you're dragging something down. Continue to turn your body and your waist. Bring both hands to the right-hand corner. Join your hands by bringing the right hand around. Touch the left wrist, and your right hand is going to push the left wrist forward. You turn your body slightly to the left, and your weight move forward to the left slightly. Then your right hand push your left wrist forward to form a semicircle in front of your chest. Separate your hands so they're shoulder width and shoulder height. As you transfer the weight backwards, bring your hands back down in a gentle curve. Then again, bring your hands further down to the hip level, again in a gentle, subtle curve. Push forward with your hands as you move your weight forward. So the force of pushing forward comes from your weight and your hip. And you move forward in a gentle, steep slope. Transfer your weight to the right and turn your left toe inwards so the left foot is facing straight ahead. Open up with your hands in a curve. Bring your hands around so you're carrying a ball. Take care it's your left hand on top and elbow slightly sink. Step your right foot forward towards the right with the toes pointing at 3 o'clock. Wall off with the right hand again. Take care to push your left heel backwards. Turn your waist slightly and turn both your palms. Roll back as you transfer your weight. Continue to turn your hands and your body. Join hands. Push forward. Separate your hands. Transfer your weight backwards and bring your hands back. And bring your hands down. Push forward in that steep curve again. Transfer your weight back to the left and turn the right toe inwards so that your right toes are facing straight ahead. Bring your left foot next to the right so that both feet are now parallel to each other and shoulder width. Bring both palms to face down. As you bring your hands down slowly, you stand up slowly. Feet together.
5. Waving hands like clouds.
Separate your feet. Hands up slowly. Hands down, bend your knee. With your waist turning slightly to the left and your body turning slightly, to the right, bring your left hand up in a gentle curve so your left palm is facing you, right palm down. as you turn your waist to the left, looking at the left palm, and when you reach the left corner, turn the left palm out, turn the right palm up. Then move both palms in gentle curve. With your waist turning and moving towards the right, again, bring your hands over in curves and turn the right hand out, turn the left hand in. Then move the left hand up, right hand down. Bring the hands around in curves so that both hands are now shoulder width and shoulder height. Press down slowly and stand up slowly. Feet together.
Six, heel kick.
Separate your feet. Hands up slowly. As you bring your hands down this time, bring them down in a curve to cross in front of the lower abdomen. Bring the right foot next to the left. Bring your hands up and bring the knee up. Turn your palms to face outwards and lift up your toe. Kick towards 130 position. And it is important, as you kick, make sure you open up your hands in a curve and your right hand is over your right foot and left hand is balanced with the right hand, roughly the same height. It can be slightly higher and the left hand is now facing 9 o'clock position. Bring your hands together, and as your weight is now on the right foot, bring your left foot next to the right. Hands up, turn palm to face out, open up and kick towards 10-30 position. Now kicking is not always easy, and not everyone can kick as high as whatever you like. So it doesn't really matter how high you kick. You can kick higher than that, or you can kick much lower, as long as you're comfortable and make your body straight and kicking with your toe bent towards you and the hands overlying the kicking foot. Cross your hands in front of the lower abdomen. Bring them up in a curve. Hands down, stand up. Feet together.
Seven, golden cock standing on one leg.
Separate your feet. Hands up slowly. Hands down, bend your knee. Turn your body slightly to the left. Bring your hands around in a curve so you're carrying a ball with the right hand on top. As you transfer your weight to the right, turn your body slightly to the right. Bring the left hand up next to the wrist with the fingers pointing up. Turn your left hand around in a spiral fashion to create a spiral force. At the same time, bring up the left knee. When you step down, let your left toe down first and As you step down, turn your body to the right and carrying a ball, this time with the left hand on top. As you turn your body to the left, bring your right hand up next to the wrist. And again, turn your right hand in spirals to bring up the right knee. As you land the right foot down, carrying a ball on the left hand side. Bring your hands out in a curve so they are shoulder height and shoulder width. Hands down slowly and stand up slowly. Feet together. I'll demonstrate this movement from the side view. Start from here. Bring your hands down, bend your knee, turn your body to the left, carrying a ball. Now here, turn the left hand around and move in spirals, take the left knee up. Then, as you landed the left foot down, carrying a ball to the right, and bring the right hand around next to the left wrist, and turn the right hand around. Then you finish off, carrying a ball, back to where we were.
Form 1, commencing form.
At the beginning, prepare yourself mentally, relax, and cleanse your mind of all thoughts. Start with your body straight, tuck your chin in slightly, relax your shoulder, leave a small space underneath the armpit. Relax your hands, so that your hands are lightly touching your thigh. Relax your hip, relax your knee. Do not push your knee backwards. Feet together. Lift your left foot up and place it to your left, so that both feet are separate by shoulder width and parallel to each other. When you lift your feet up, make sure you lift the heel first. And when your foot touches down, make sure the ball of the foot touches ground first. Bring your hands up slowly and gently, as though there's two invisible balloons lifting up your hands. Maintain shoulder width, shoulder height. Press down gently, as though you're pressing down these two balloons. Make sure your palm is parallel to the ground and the hands to reach the same level as your belly button. Once your hands press down, start bending your knee. Once your hand reach the belly button level, your knee should reach a position where the kneecap is at the same line as your toes. As you press your hands down, breathe out. And previously, as you bring your hands up, breathe in.
Form 2, parting wild horse's mane, left, right, and left.
bring both hands in curves to look as though you're carrying a ball with the right hand on top, palm face each other, the ball away from the body. Step your left foot out so that the left foot are facing 9 o'clock. As you transfer your weight, turn your waist, and this carries the hands. This creates a force to separate the hands so that the left hand open up to shoulder height, right hand brush down next to the hip, just in front of the hip, finger face forward, form a left bow stance. Transfer your weight backwards. Take care to keep your body straight. Turn towards the left so that your body and your left toes are facing 7:30. Turn the left hand down so that you're carrying a ball with the left hand on top. Step the right foot out, straight face 9 o'clock. Again, with the force of your hip turning and your weight transferring, separate your hands. Transfer your weight. Turn to the right now, facing 10:30. Carrying a ball with the right hand on top, be sure that your left foot comes around and with the ball of the foot touching ground, not too far from the right foot. Step forward with the left foot. The third, parting wild horse's mane.
Form two, parting wild horse's mane, left, right and left from a different angle. Form 3, white crane flashing wings.
Take a half step forward with the right foot. Turn your body slightly to the left. Turn the left hand upside down to carry a ball. Sit back on the right foot. Put your weight back on the right foot, and as you turn your waist around, carry your hands over to the right and bring both hands slightly closer. Turn your waist, straighten your body so that your body is facing 9 o'clock. As you do that, open up your hands. So right hand is eye level, left hand next to the hip and in front of the hip. At the end, loosen up your left foot forward a little bit to form the left anti-stance. I'll now demonstrate this movement from a different angle. Half a step forward, slightly turn to the left, carrying the ball, Bring the ball to the right. Don't stand up here. Separate your hands. Look ahead. Loosen up the left foot forward a little bit.
Form 4. Brush knee, right, left and right.
With the slight movements of your hip, bring your right hand down, left hand up. With the movement of the hips, take the hands around so that you're looking at the right hand, left hand pass in front of your face to rest next to your elbow, to guard the elbow. Bring the left foot next to the right. Step forward with the left foot so that the toes are pointing at 9 o'clock. Left hand brushes past your knee as your right hand pushes from next to your ear. So right hand's about chest height. Transfer your weight backwards. Make sure you don't stand up here and keep your body straight. Turn towards 45 degree, facing 7:30. As you turn, you bring your right hand around, the left hand up, so the right hand is guarding the left elbow, and the left hand is facing up. Step forward with the right foot. Again, the same, on reverse direction, right hand brush passes knee, left hand pushes out. Transfer your weight, make sure you lift your toe up. Turn, be sure you turn with your waist. And again, bring the hands around. Step forward. Brush knee third time. When I mention turn with your hip, what I mean is as you transfer your weight back and when you turn around, do not just turn your toe out, but turn with your waist or your hip that way. And by turning with your body, then your body take your toe to turn.
Form 4, brush knee, right, left and right from a different angle. Form 5, playing the lute.
Bring the right foot half a step forward and the right hand continue to push forward a little bit as a continuation of the previous move. Sit back on the right foot and as you turn your waist around, bring your hands back. Then as you turn your waist back to the left to have your body face 9 o'clock, closing with your hands so that the right hand is guarding the left elbow. And at the very end, stretch out your hands a tiny little bit.
Form 5, playing the lute from a different angle. Form 6. Repulse monkey, right, left, right, left.
First of all, turn the right palm face up, bring it slowly next to the hip. As you turn with your hip to the right side, bring the right hand over, so that the right hand is pointing at 130, and look back. Bring the right hand next to your ear, look straight ahead, bring the left hand back slightly, bring the left foot back. As you step back, three things happen. The right hand push forward past the palm of the left hand at one stage to be in front of you. Your left hand come back in a curve to end up next and in front of your hip with the palm face upwards. And as you step back, slowly transfer your weight back to the left foot. Your left toe is facing 730, and as you step back, bring your foot back in a curve to pass the right foot. And turn both hands with the movement of the hip towards the left, bring the left hand up. So the left hand is now facing 430. And again, bring the left hand next to the ear. Step back with the right foot. And now the right toe is pointing at 10:30. And push your left hand forward. Be sure both feet are separate by a shoulder width. Again, open up. Step back again. Continue this four times. There's four, continue the same. Four repulse monkey. Okay, bring the left hand back next to the ear. Push forward. Maintain your body straight and don't stand up. Here, the last one, you ended a little bit different. Landed with the right toe on the ground first, then turn the right heel inwards so that the right toes are pointing straight ahead. Bring your right hand around in a curve and left hand down to carry a ball in front of you with the palm face each other. Bring the left foot next to the right.
Form 7, stroking bird's tail left.
Turn your body slightly to the left. Step your left foot towards the left. Toes pointing at 9 o'clock. As you turn your waist to the left and transfer the weight forward to the left, wall off with your left hand, so the left arm here forms a circular curve, elbow slightly lower, and palm face you, same height as the middle of the chest. Let your right hand come down in a curve to in front and next to the right hip. As you turn your waist slightly to the left, turn both palms towards 7:30. Transfer your weight back and roll back with both your hands as though you are dragging down something. Continue to transfer your weight and turn your waist to the right towards 1:30 position. Bring the right hand around, right palm next to the left wrist. As you turn the waist back and transfer your weight towards the left, with the right hand push the left arm forward to form a semicircle with both your arms symmetrical. Open up slowly, palm face down, shoulder height, shoulder width. Transfer your weight back and bring your hands back in a curve. Continue to sink back a little bit and bring your hands down in a curve. As you shift your weight forward, with that strength of the weight forward, push your palms forward as though you're going up a steep slope. I'll demonstrate this movement in a different angle. Step your left foot forward, wall off with your left hand, looking straight ahead. Turn your waist and turn your hands to the corner. Roll back, transfer your weight. Then continue to turn. And then turn your right hand around and straighten yourself up, push forward a tiny little bit. Then continue to push forward. And then separate your hands, shoulder width, shoulder height. Continue to shift your weight back, bring your hands down along your body. Then as you go forward, bring your weight forward, looking straight ahead.
Form 8, stroking bird's tail right.
Transfer your weight to the right. Turn your left toe inwards to face straight ahead. Open up, look at the right side. And then bring your hands around in a curve to carry a ball with the left hand on top. Bring the right foot next to the left. Step your right foot forward towards 3 o'clock. As you turn your waist around, wall off with the right arm. Again, turn your waist slightly to the right, turn both palms. Roll back. Continue to turn. Left hand join the right hand. And push forward towards 3 o'clock, form a semicircle. Open up both hands, then weight back, make sure your body is straight, palms down in a curve, then go forward in a curve.
Form 9, single whip.
Transfer your weight and turn your right toe inwards to face straight ahead. Bring your hands around. Continue to transfer your weight to the left and bring your hands around in curves. Then bring the right hand up in curves, left hand down. Transfer your weight back to the right, and as you bring the right hand to face 130, make a hook with the right hand. You're now looking at 130, looking at left palm, and bring the left foot next to the right. Turn slightly to the left, step the left foot to the left towards 9 o'clock. As you transfer your weight to the left, turn your waist to the left, looking at the left hand, and bring your left hand to face 9 o'clock. At the end, turn the left palm to face out. And keep your right hand at the same position, facing 130. And at the very end, qi xin to the dang tiang. Notice your right heel, as you form the left bolstang, your right heel actually push backwards with the strength of your right hip.
Form 10, waving hands like clouds times 3.
Transfer weight to the right. Turn your left toe inwards so the toes are facing straight ahead. Bring your left hand down in a curve. Bring your left hand up in a curve and open up the right hand. Moving left hand up in a curve, right hand down. Turn towards the left hand corner as you transfer your weight towards the left. And once your left hand reaches the corner, turn the palm so that the left palm is facing out. Turn the right palm so the right palm is facing up. And at the same time, bring the right foot next to the left. When you move your foot in this, in most of the time, lift the heel up first, and then when you touch down with the ball of the foot first. And when both feet are close in this movement, they should be separated by slightly more than 2 fist distance. Bring the right hand up, left hand down in a gentle curve. Turn, bring both hands around in a curve to the right side and turn the right palm out, left palm up, and step out with the left foot so that both of the feet are separated by roughly 2 shoulder width. Now, if you find it difficult to do that because it will make your stance a lot lower, then it's quite all right to make it a little bit narrower. So, left hand up, right hand down. Okay. As you bring the left hand over, turn the palms out, bring the right palm up, and bring the right foot next to the left. This is the second crowd hangs. Right hand up, left hand down. Bring your hands over in a curve, step out. Left hand up, right hand down. Turn towards the left, that's the last crouch hangs. Right hand up, left hand down, remember to bring it down in a curve. Turn towards 130 position, make a hook with the right hand, bring the left hand next to the right elbow, and bring the left foot next to the right, forming a left anti-stance.
Form 11, single whip.
step your left foot out to the left, toes pointing at 9 o'clock. As you transfer your weight to the left, turn your waist to the left, looking at the left palm, and when the left palm reaches at the end, turn your left palm outwards. Keep the right hook hang at the same position where you started at 1:30.
Form 12, High Horse.
Step half a step forward with the right foot. Open up both palms to face diagonally up. Transfer your weight to the right foot and bring the right hand next to your ear, left hand back slightly. Push the right hand forward to be in front of you with the wrist on the ankle of 45 degrees. Bring the left hand back next to the hip, palm face up. Shift your left foot slightly to form the left anti-stance.
Form 13, heel kick right.
Bring the left hand past the right hand. Turn the left palm outwards and take your left foot up. Step it slightly forward to the left, pointing at 7:30. Bring your hands around in a curve to form a cross hang in front of the lower abdomen. Bring the right foot next to the left. As you stand up a little bit, bring your cross hands upwards and bend your knee. As you turn your palm outwards, lift the toe upwards. Open up both your hands in a curve. So right hand is overlying the right foot. You kick hang towards 10:30 position. Make sure you bend your toe upwards. And the other hand should be balanced about the same height. The left hand is allowed to be slightly higher for balance. Once you do the kick, it is important to take note that you're looking at where you're kicking, and your hand is on top of where you're kicking. But it's not so important how high you can kick. Not everyone feels comfortable kicking very high up. So it's quite okay if you kick like this, if that's comfortable for you. Make sure you bend your toe upwards and your hands still over there.
Form 13, heel kick right from a different angle. Form 14, punching ears with both fists.
Turn both palms upwards, bend your knee, cut across with both palms to be above your knee. Turn the hands so that the palms are facing out, and bring the hands around in curve. Step down with the right foot towards 10:30. Make two fists punches forward towards temporal height as you shift your weight forward to form the right bow stance. And be sure your elbow is facing downwards, not like this. And shoulder relaxed. Look at 10:30.
Form 14, punching ears with both fists from a different angle. Form 15, turn and heel kick left.
Transfer your weight backwards. Make sure your back is straight. Turn your body so that you are facing 7:30. Turn your right toe inwards so that the toes are facing 7:30. Open your fists, open up your hands in a curve, looking at the left hand, transfer your weight to the right. Bring your hands around to cross in front of your lower abdomen. Bring the left foot back close to the right. Bring your hands upwards as you bend your knee. Turn your hands outwards and lift your toe upwards. Kick towards 4:30 position. Look at where you're kicking.
Form 15, turn and heel kick left from a different angle. Form 16, lower movement and golden cock stands on one leg, left.
Bring your right hand over and make a hook with the right hand to point at 7:30 position. Bring your left hand around next to the right elbow, face away from you. Bring the left foot next to the right. If you find it difficult, your left toe can touch ground. Step down with the left foot with the toe pointing 6 o'clock. As you lower yourself down, turn the left palm outwards. Trace the left hands along the left leg. Turn the left toe outwards to face 3 o'clock. As you transfer your weight now forward, bring the left hand up. The hook on the right hand is now pointing upwards. And turn the right toe inwards so the toes are pointing at 4:30 position. Turn your left toe outwards slightly to face 1:30. Come up slowly. Then bring the right hand up as though the right hand is taking the right knee up. Elbow pointing at the knee. I'll demonstrate this movement from the opposite direction. From the kick here. Then turn. Then step down. Keep the hook up there. Turn the left hands. Then sink down, trace your hands, turn your toe, then move your weight forward, turn the right toe inwards, make the left hand hook, turn the left toe outwards, bring your right hand up.
Form 17, lower movement and golden cock stands on one leg, right.
Touch down with the right foot, toes down first, then land it with the whole foot, toe face straight ahead, then turn towards the left with the left hand forms a hook pointing at 10:30. Then lift the left heel up and turn it inwards so that your left toe is now facing 10-30. Step down with the right foot. Turn your right hand. Trace it along the leg. Turn your right toe. Shift your weight forward. Then get ready. Bring your left knee up to form the golden cock standing on one leg. I will now demonstrate the feet movements in a close-up view. First of all, turn your body towards the left. Bring the right foot down with the ball of the foot touching ground first, then the whole foot. Your right foot is now facing straight ahead. Lift your left foot up, lift up the left heel only, and turn your left heel inwards so that now your left toe is pointing at 10-30. Now you're ready to bend down and step your right foot forward to do the lowering movement.
Form 18, Fair Lady, work at shuttles, right, left.
Step your left foot forward with the toes pointing at 130, carrying a ball with the left hand on top. Turn to your waist, step your right foot down to towards 430. Bring your right hand around to place to protect your head with your arms in curve, relax your shoulder, and push your left hand forward to chest height. Transfer your weight backwards and open up your hands. Turn your right toe very slightly outwards and bring hands together to carrying a ball, this time with the right hand on top. Step forward with the left foot towards 130. And bring your left hand around to protect your head. Push forward with the right hand. I'll do a demonstration from a front-on position. Carrying a ball, step the right foot forward, turn the right hand, push out with the left hand, then transfer your weight, turn the right toe slightly outwards, open up your hands, carrying the ball, step the left foot out, and push forward to the left side.
Form 19, needle at sea bottom.
Step half a step forward and turn your body around. Bring the left hand in front of you, the right hand down. As you push your left hand down, bring the right hand up over here. So three things happens here. The left hand brush past your left knee. The right hand comes down in a curve from next to your ear to here. And loosen your left foot forward to form a left empty stance. Right fingers are facing down. I'll demonstrate this from a different angle. Half a step forward, turn your body, bring the right hand up, left hand down, brush knee with the left hand, push down with the right hand, finger face down, move your left foot over to form a left empty stance. Keep your body straight.
Form 20, fan back.
Join your hands. Bring your left hand next to the right wrist. Turn your right palm to face away and move the left foot forward a tiny little bit, and now you're touching your heel instead. And open up your palms in curves so both palms are facing similar direction, with the right palm to protect your head, left palm straight out. I'll demonstrate this from the opposite direction. First of all, stand up a little, join your hands, turn your palms, change your left foot so that you're on the heel, open up and push your weight forward, look ahead.
Form 21. Turn to deflect downward, parry and punch.
Transfer your weight to the right and turn your body slightly to the right. At the same time, turn the left toe inwards so that the toes are now facing 7:30. Continue to swing your body around so your left hand is top of your head, right hand making a fist next to your armpit or hidden underneath there, and you are now facing towards 7:30. So three things happens here. The left hand comes down as though it's going to block a punch. The right fist punches out in front of you towards the nose. And your right foot step forward with the toes turning outwards. So in this case, the toes is pointing at 10:30. Swing your arms around so that the right fist ended up next to your hip with palm face up, left hand extend out in front of your chest, and move forward with your left foot in a curve towards 9 o'clock. As you shift your weight forward, punches and turn your fist so that your fist is now facing with the thumb side, facing inwards. And bring your left hand slowly backwards to end it up guarding the elbow. I'll demonstrate this from the opposite direction. Transfer your weight, turn your left toe inwards. Bring the fist under, pat down with the left hand, punch out with the right fist. Then turn your body, left hand forward, step your left foot forward, punch forward, left hand back slowly.
Form 22, apparent closing up.
Bring your left hand underneath the elbow. Open up both hands so that they're shoulder width. As you bring your hands back, sit back, transfer your weight back. Bring your hands down in a curve. As you transfer your weight forward, push both hands up in a stiff curve, like this.
Form 23, cross hands.
Turn your body around to the right. Transfer your weight to the right and turn the left toe inwards to face in front. Continue to turn your body to the right and open up your palms. At the same time, turn the right toe outwards to face 130. Okay. Bring the right foot next to the left so that both feet are separated by a shoulder width, parallel to each other. Bring the hands close together to cross in front of you at the lower abdomen. As you bring your hands up slowly, stand up slowly.
Form 24, closing form.
Slowly turn your palms so that it's facing down. Press your hands down gently, like a reverse V shape, and bring them beside your thigh. Lift the left heel up first, bring the left foot next to the right. This is the closing form.
This ends the 24 Forms video. Please remember, the most important way to gain maximum enjoyment and benefits from Tai Chi Chuan is to practice regularly. It would be very helpful and beneficial to learn from an experienced teacher if you have not already done so.